States not backing it. Neither is Britain. What we're talking about is a United Nations resolution condemning China's human rights record. It's a major blow for rights campaigners who say abuses continue as we speak. But Washington and London believe China is progressing. As testimony, Beijing has even vowed to sign the UN Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, although no date has yet been announced. As the UN Commission on Human Rights opens its annual meeting in Geneva today, there will be one voice telling the West not to be fooled. Inside Story's Susan Yu traveled to London, where she caught up with Wei Jingsheng, China's most famous dissident and Beijing's worst enemy. She spoke to him at the start of his two-month European tour and finds out his message is simple. Pushing Beijing to improve its human rights record isn't bad for business. It's the only way to do business with China.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, accompanied by the President of the People's Republic of China.
Let me again say how pleased we are to welcome a leader of a great people with a remarkable civilization, history, and culture. People now with its focus.
Things couldn't be better for Beijing. Constructive engagement has become more than just diplomatic and political speak, with the American President Bill Clinton expected to make a trip to the Chinese capital this June or July. Across the Atlantic, it seems Europe is following suit. The European Union last month decided not to back a proposal critical of rights abuses in China. Britain currently holds the EU presidency. And last week, in response to criticisms in the Commons that the Labour government is soft-pedaling on China, Prime Minister Tony Blair told Parliament that continuing to condemn China is just not the right way to proceed.
It's the first time in 9 years that the British government has decided not to back a UN draft resolution condemning Beijing for its human rights record. Now that gives Chinese dissidents all the more reason to press their message home. 2 months and traveling to 10 countries seem to be a small price to be paid for Wei Jingsheng, who spent half his lifetime in prison.
We caught up with Wei a day after his meeting with British Foreign Secretary Robin Cook. Cook had refused to see him back in January. While the British Foreign Secretary told Wei Britain's China policy is an ethical one, the 47-year-old dissident left the meeting unimpressed and unconvinced.我希望他们能及时的纠正这种态度。库克外长呢，他也承认他们这个政策呢，没有什么太多的道理，而且他自己也承认他自己也不喜欢这种立场。但是我觉得英国政府呢，很明显的采取了一种明知道是错误的又不愿意改正，而且还要采取掩饰的这种做法，就是昨天关于记者发生的那件事情，他们好像很巧妙地做出了安排，使所有的记者呢，没有见到我就已经走了，使我从外交部出来的时候呢，记者们事先就走了。我觉得这种做法是一种很不道德的、很不正派的做法。
The media had shown up for a pre-arranged protocol, but they found themselves turned away by Foreign Office officials after being told that Cook's meeting with Wei had already finished.
Can you tell us why you think the British government has a two-faced policy towards China regarding human rights?
一方面，他们口头上说他们很关心其他国家，包括中国国家的人权状况，而且他们也明确说，昨天库克外长明确地说，
Before Hong Kong's handover, Britain said it had a moral obligation to Hong Kong. Do you think that it's going to be able to fulfill that obligation in light of what's happened?
可能对于英国来说，中国和香港一样的遥远。他们既然不愿意关心整个中国人民的状况的话，他又怎么可能非常关心香港人民的状况？
One thing's for sure, if profits and potential are anything to go by, China gets top marks as more and more countries seek to enhance ties with Beijing. And according to Wei, it's principles that are getting sidelined.
他们还不仅仅是不重视，而是呢，采取了一种向共产党妥协的态度。这样的共产党受到鼓励以后，对国内的老百姓呢，采取的迫害啊，或者是镇压的措施也就会更严厉了。实际上，现在北京和上海就有很多从事民主活动的人，很快的被逮捕了。就在这个欧盟外长会议做出决议之后不几天，他们就被逮捕。
China is doing relatively well as far as its economy is concerned. Do you think your ideas about the Fifth Modernisation, the fact that you need democracy for economic prosperity, does not apply anymore?
实际上，大部分的中国人，包括大部分外国人，现在都认为，我20年前提出来的这个第五个现代化，看得越来越清楚。在中国没有民主化的话，这个其他各种现代化，包括经济的进步。 也是很难做到的。实际上，现在中国经济状况非常糟糕，而不是像共产党自己说的那样好。中国的经济状况这么糟糕，很多的经济学家，他们原来单纯从经济方面研究中国，但是呢，研究来研究去，他们发现中国的经济问题不能解决。之所以造成现在那么多人的失业，造成很多的经济难题，关键的原因，最终的原因，还是因为共产党这种
It's expected that Zhu Rongji will be the next premier. Does that make you more optimistic about China?
根据我的不太完全的了解，朱镕基这个人还是比较富有正义感的，比较愿意为中国做一些事情的，比李鹏好的强得多。但是现在中国的问题不是哪一个人出来就能解决的，它是一个整体制度的问题。 即使朱镕基他的愿望再好，恐怕他也不能够从根本上解决中国的问题。当然，如果他能够大幅度的在政治上进行改革，能够顶得住共产党内部保守派那个反动派的压力，这样也许给中国能够带来一个比较乐观的前途。但是我们看到前面胡耀邦、赵紫阳的例子，我们对朱镕基的前途也不是非常乐观。
You've had problems getting your book published. What are your thoughts about what happened to the former governor Chris Patten and his situation with Rupert Murdoch?
我觉得这个这件事情一方面说明共产党无孔不入，他并不是把他的政治局限于中国的边界之内，并不是仅仅压迫迫害，或者剥夺了中国人民的人权，甚至不但中国人在外国写书，而且外国人在外国写书好像也要得到他的批准。 他已经把他的政治延伸到了英国来，这一点我想不但中国人要注意他，而且英国人恐怕也要思考思考这个问题。And
what about the influence of rights campaigners like Wei? Are they becoming more and more isolated as it becomes perhaps more politically incorrect to back them?
Do you think that you meant more to the cause while you were in prison than while you're out of prison?
我想我在国外也能起很大的作用，而且能够比在监狱里起更大的作用。实际上，我觉得一个人在监狱里，他本身就不能起太大的作用。但是我在监狱里待着，主要的原因就是因为我要坚持我的原则，我不能在我的原则上后退。到国外来呢，我还可以做很多的实际工作，所以我至少我出来以后发现，我在这边能做的工作非常多。
Do you think that we're going to have the same conversation a year from now?
如果你的老板没有完全的听从共产党的指挥的话，我想会有这种机会的。<laughs>
Do you ever feel as though it's a hopeless cause and you just want to give up?
有的时候我看到那些有很多的中国人，他们宁可让别人做牺牲，自己等在那里，他们不是不明白道理。 但是他们等在那里，觉得你们两个可以去斗，你们无论哪个取胜，我都不会吃亏。我看到很多人是这样的时候，我确实有的时候感到有些灰心。但是反过来我看看，我觉得不光中国人是这样，其他有很多民族的人，
他们在没有争取到民主制度之前，他们在受压迫的状况下，有的时候可能也是必然会产生这种现象的。所以我觉得这个也没有什么了不起的。总归是有很多的中国人，他们愿意做出牺牲，他们和其他国家人民一样勇敢，甚至可能更勇敢。你看看天安门广场的老百姓，所以我就又同时又觉得很有信心了，没有必要灰心。
What is the objective of your trip to Europe? What kind of message do you want to send to the countries here?
最大的目的就是向西方各国的人民和政府说明中国的情况，争取使西方的国家能够更多的支持中国的人权和民主活动，能够更多的支持中国的老百姓。 一个国家、一个民族，如果没有人来，做出牺牲，大家都只顾自己过小日子，都不愿意为整个社会的公共的利益做出牺牲的话，那么这个社会就会变得很糟糕。最后，所有人的利益都没有保障。我们中国的情况可能就是这样的。所以，在这方面，你看看西方这些民主国家。 他们的这个民主，他们的制度得来的也不容易，而且现在要保持这种制度，也还是需要付出很多的代价的。所以，我们中国人应该有这个勇气来付出代价。实际上，我们100多年来也已经付出了很多的代价。如果我们在最后的这个时刻不努力，那么恐怕我们谁也享受不到自由，享受不到民主了。